A very warm welcome to all my dear students. In this video, we will see the unit for electronics component and signal of basic electrical and electronics engineering subject of mechanical engineering branch. Now, these are the course outcomes of this video. You are able to differentiate the active and passive electronics components. You are able to know the use of passive components in the electronic circuit. You are able to calculate the value of resistors and capacitor by using color coding. Now, what is the electronics? Electronics is the branch of science that deals with the development and application of devices and systems involving with the flow of electrons in the vacuums, gases and semiconductors. Now, students, what are the electronics components? Electronic components are the components used in the designing and assembling of electronic circuits. So now we will see the classification of electronics components. Basically, electronics components are classified into two classes, active components and passive components. Again, in active components, there are two types, electronics tubes and semiconductor devices. In semiconductor devices, there are number of examples like diode, transistors, FET, etc. In passive components, there are three basic types or three examples like resistors, capacitors and inductors. So in this video, we will see only the passive components, that means resistors, capacitors and inductors. Now we will see the what are active components and passive components. Active components are the those components which can perform the signal processing functions like the signal generation, amplification and rectification and so on. So what is meaning of amplification? Amplification means what? To increase the strength of weak signal, and rectification means what? To convert AC into DC. So active components are the components which are used for used for the signal processing function like the signal generation, amplification and rectification are called active components. Active components are able to provide the gain, power gain. That means what? Active components are used for the amplification process. Active components require the energy to operate. They require the external energy to operate. Now, and examples of active components are diode, transistor, SCR, FET, thyristor, etc. Now, what are the passive components? Passive components are those components which cannot perform the signal processing functions like amplification, signal generation and rectification, but they help the active components to do their desired operation. So passive components, these are the components which cannot use for the signal processing function, but they help the active components to do their operation. Okay, so now passive components, they do not provide a power gain. That means that they are not used for the amplification function. Passive components do not require external energy to operate. An example of passive components are the inductor, resistor and capacitors. So three example of passive components are resistor, inductor and capacitor. Now we will see the difference between active and passive components. We already seen what are the active components and passive components. Now we will differentiate the active component and passive component. Active components are those components which can perform the signal processing function like the signal generation, amplification and rectification and so on are called active components. while the basic components are those components which cannot perform the signal processing function, but they help the active component to do their operation, so are called passive components. Active components cannot provide the active components provide the power gain, and these are used for the amplification, while passive component cannot provide the power gain and not used for the amplification. Active component require the external energy to operate, while the passive component do not require the energy to operate. Examples, as you know, diode, transistor, FET, SCR, these are the example of active components. Example of passive components are resistor, inductor and capacitor. Mostly the active components are unidirectional and passive components are bidirectional. So in this video we will see the passive components, that means all resistor, inductor and capacitor. So one by one we will see the resistor, inductor and capacitor. Now what is the resistor? Resistor is the passive component that opposes or control or regulates the flow of electric current. The resistor is a passive component that opposes the flow of electric current. And what is the resistance means what? The opposition to the flow of current is called resistance. Resistance is denoted by R. So this is the symbol of resistor. So in this slide, fixed resistor and variable resistor symbol has been shown. So next one is what? Classification of resistor. Resistors are classified into two types, linear resistor and non-linear resistor. Linear resistor, there are again two types, fixed resistor and variable. And in fixed resistor, again there are types according to the type of material used for the making of resistor. So carbon composition, metal film, wire wound, these are the types of fixed resistor. In variable resistor, again there are three types, wire wound, potentiometer and trimmer. And in non-linear resistor, there are three types, varistor, thermistor and LDR. Now we will see the specifications of resistors. Resistance value or resistivity, then tolerance, power rating, thermal stability, maximum operating temperature, maximum operating voltage. These are the specifications of resistors. Now next topic is resistor color coding. What is color coding? Color coding is the process by which we can obtain the resistance value by observing the resistor only. So this is the resistor, how the resistor looks. In the resistor there are different color bands. Color bands may be 4 or color band may be 5. In first one resistor there are 4 bands. In the second one resistor there are 5 bands. So this is the chart for color coding. So first color for the color coding is what? Black. Second one is what? Brown. Third one is red. Fourth one is orange. Then next one is yellow. Then green, blue, violet, gray, white, gold and silver. So value of black is what? 0. Then brown is 1, red is 2, orange is 3, yellow is 4, green is 5, blue is 6, violet is 7, gray is 8, white is 9, like this. Now in this case mostly gold and silver, these are the used for the tolerance. These are the last band. these are in the last color band. Okay, so now in this case, if the first color band indicates the first digit, for the four color band register, for first band is for the first digit, second band is for the second digit, third band for the multiplier, and fourth one is for the tolerance. But if there are five bands, color bands in the register, so first band indicates what? First digit, second band indicates second digit, third band indicates third digit, and fourth band indicates multiplier, and fifth band indicates tolerance. Okay, so last band is always tolerance. So for tolerance, this is the last column, first band, these are the digits for the first band, second band, third band, for having the same digits. Multiplier is what? 10 into 1 for black, into 10 for red, 100 into 100, and so on. So like this is a multiplier, and last one is what? Tolerance. Tolerance band always a last band. So tolerance band for the gold is 5%, and for the silver it is 10%, and it is 1% plus minus 1% for the brown, and plus minus 2% for the red, and it is 5 plus minus 5% for the gold, and it is 5 plus minus 5% for the silver. Okay, so this is about the color coding chart. Now, so color coding, it is a method by which we can obtain the resistance value of resistor by observing the only the resistor. So now numericals on the color coding. So suppose numerical, suppose given 150 ohms plus minus 5%. So in this case, one indicates what? Brown. Say 5 means what? Green. And third one is what? Here multiplier. Multiplier will be what? Into 10. So 1, 5 into 10 will be what? 150. So value of resistor will be what? 150 ohms. And plus minus 5% has been given. That means what? Color band, last tolerance band will be what? Gold. For gold there is a 5%. So what will be color bands for the 150 ohms resistor will be brown, green, brown, gold. These are the color bands for the 150 ohms plus minus 5% resistor. So this is first example. Now second example is what? 2.7 kilo ohms plus minus 10%. 10% means what? Silver. 2.7 kilo ohms. Now 2 means what? Which band? Red. Okay, and 7 means what? Violet. 7 number for the violet. And next one is what? For red. Now into 27 into 100 will become what? 2700 ohms. 2700 ohms means what? 2700 ohms means what? 2.7 kilo ohms. So what will be third band? Red band. So that means what? 27 into 100 we will get 2700 ohms. So third band will be what here? Red. And what will be fourth band? Silver, because it is tolerance is what here? 10%. So silver. So what will be color bands for the 2.7 kilo ohms? Red, violet, red, and silver. Understood, students? Now next example is for the 56 kilo ohms plus minus 20%. Now in this case, if the 20% tolerance is there, that means what? There is no band. For the no band, there is a 20% tolerance. So first 5 indicates what? Which color? Green. 6 indicates what? Which color? Blue. 56. Now in here 56, this is the first 5 is what? First digit. 6 is what? Second digit. So for 5 there is which color? Green. Or 6, which color? Blue. Now here kilo means what? 1000. So we have to multiply 56 in by 1000. So for 1000, which what will be multiplier? Orange. So we have to so third band will be what? Orange. And here tolerance is given 20%, that means what? No band. So what will be color band for the 56 kilo ohm plus minus 20%? Green, blue, orange, and no band or plain. So this is about the third example. Now next example we will see. Resistance value has been given 10 mega ohms. 10 mega ohms for first band. For one digit, what is the band? Color band? Brown. For zero, what is color band? Black. And for brown, what is the color band? Brown. Okay, so brown. For zero, what is second digit is what here? Zero. For zero, what is the color band? Black. So first band is what? Brown. Second band is what? Black. Now mega. Mega means what? 10 raised to 6. So 10 raised to 6 means what? Which 10 raised to 6, for 10 raised to 6, what is the multiplier? For the 10 raised to 6, so what will be multiplier here, students? 10 raised to 6 means what? Blue. So for solving these numericals, student, you have to remember this color coding chart. This is the must. So what will be third band? Blue band. And what is tolerance has been given? 10% plus minus 10%. 10% means what? Which color band? Silver. Okay, so what will be color coding for this 10 mega ohms plus minus 10%? Brown, black, blue, and silver. So this is the color. These are the color bands for the 10 mega ohms plus minus 10%. Okay, so like this numerical will be there in examination. Either you will get the values from the values of resistance, you have to find the color bands, or from the color bands you have to obtain the resistance value. So second type of numerical is what? Here color bands has been given, and from the color bands you have to obtain the resistance value. So for what is your example? Determine what is numerical. Determine the resistance and tolerance rating for the following 4 band color codes. So what is for the color code? Brown, black, and yellow. So students, what is the value for the brown? Brown means what? 1. Black means what? 0. Okay, so brown is 1, black means what? 0. Okay, and then yellow. Third band is what here? Yellow. Yellow means what? In 4 band resistors, first band is for first digit, second band for second digit, third band for the multiplier. So what will be multiplier here? Yellow. For the yellow, what is the value? 10 raised to 4. 10 raised to 4. So 10 into 10 raised to 4. And what will be tolerance here? No tolerance, no band is given for the tolerance. So what will be percentage of tolerance? 20 plus minus 20%. So if the no tolerance has been given, that means what you have to consider? Plus minus 20%. Okay, so in this case what will be value? 10 into 10,000. 10 means what? 10 into 10,000. 10 into 10,000 means what? 100 kilo ohms. And what will be tolerance here? Plus minus 20%. So what will be value of this color band? Brown, black, yellow, no band. What will be value for this? 100 kilo ohms. Plus minus 20%. So like this you have to obtain the resistance value from the color band also. Okay students, next passive component is inductor. Inductor is a passive component which stores the energy in the form of electromagnetic field. Inductance, it is a property of inductor. It is denoted by L. Unit of inductance is H. Basically, inductor consisting the number of turns of metal wire, metal coil, or inductor also called coil or choke. It stores the energy in the form of electromagnetic field. Inductor passes DC and blocks the AC. Inductor has a property to pass the DC and block AC. So inductor presents a low impedance part for the DC and it provides the high impedance part to the AC. So this is a symbol of inductor. So students, basically inductor is a metal coil with the number of turns of metal coil. Now we will see the classification of inductor. In inductor there are basically two types, fixed inductor and variable inductor. In fixed inductor there are two types, air core and core. In core there again there are two types, iron core and ferrite core. In variable inductor there are two types, lug tune and tap tune. Now here the symbol of air core has been given, iron core has been given, ferrite core has been given and variable core has been given. Now application of inductor. Inductor basically used in the oscillators, it is used in the filter circuit, it is used in the relays, it is used as a solenoid, it is used in the motors, then it is used in the tune circuits, it is used in the amplifiers, tune amplifiers. So these are the applications of inductor. Now the specifications of inductor. Inductance of coil, inductive reactance, it is denoted by XL is equal to 2πfL. Then self inductance, mutual inductance, coefficient of coupling and quality factors. So these are the specifications of inductor. Now third passive component is capacitor. Capacitor is a passive electronics component that stores the energy in the form of electrostatic field like a battery. It stores the energy in the form of electric field or electrostatic field, while inductor store the energy in the form of electromagnetic field or magnetic field. So this is the difference between inductor and capacitor. Inductor store the energy in the form of electromagnetic field and capacitor store the energy in the form of electrostatic field. So basically capacitor consisting two conducting surfaces or two conductors which are separated by insulating material, that is, that material is called dielectric. So basically capacitor consisting two conducting plates, which are construction of the capacitor has been shown here in the slide. So capacitor consisting two conducting surfaces or plates which are separated by insulating material, that is called dielectric. Now capacitor passes AC and blocks DC. This is a property of capacitor, passes AC and blocks the DC, while inductor passes DC and block AC. So this is a symbol of capacitor. C is what? Capacitance of capacitor. Capacitance is denoted by C. The capacitance is the ability of capacitors to store the energy. Capacitance is the ability of capacitor to store the energy. It is denoted by C. So how the capacitor looks? It is shown here. Now next topic is classification of capacitor. So according to the which basically capacitors are classified into two types, fixed and variable, as like the resistor and inductor, fixed and variable. Then in fixed there are two types, electrolytic and electrostatic. Electrolytic and electrostatic. In electrolytic there will be polarities to the terminals of capacitor. In capacitor there are two terminals. So in electrolytic capacitor there will be polarities to the terminals, positive and negative. But in electrostatic capacitor there will be no polarity. Any terminal we can place in the electronic circuit. So this is about the fixed capacitor and variable capacitor. In variable capacitor there are four types, ceramic, air, mica and plastic. Again in electrostatic there are four types, mica, ceramic, plastic and paper. So according to the which type of dielectric material used in the making of capacitor, there are four types, mica, ceramic, plastic and paper. Okay, so these are the four materials which are the used as a dielectric in between two conducting plates or conductors in the capacitor. So here already I have told electrolytic means what? They are polarized capacitors. Electrolytic means or there will be polarities, so they are polarized capacitor used for the large amount of capacitance, are used when the large amount of capacitance is required, and while the electrostatic capacitors are non-polarized capacitor. So for non-polarized capacitor there are no polarities, and polarized capacitor there are the polarities to the terminals. So these are the symbol for the non-polarized and polarized capacitors. Now next topic is what? Specifications of capacitors. So this is only listing given the capacitive reactance. It is denoted by XC. XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. F is what here? Frequency. And C is what? Capacitance. So XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. Next one is what? Power factor, dissipation factor, voltage rating, insulation resistance, tolerance and temperature coefficient. Now next one is what are the applications of capacitors. Capacitors are used in the integrator circuit, differentiator circuit. Then it is used in oscillator circuit. It is used in a filter circuit, it is used in a multivibrator circuit, and it is used in the amplifiers. So this is Now the specifications of inductor: inductance of coil, inductive reactance, it is denoted by XL is equal to 2 pi FL. Then self inductance, mutual inductance, coefficient of coupling and quality factor. So these are the specifications of inductor. Now third passive component is capacitor. Capacitor is a passive electronics component that store the energy in the form of electrostatic field, like a battery. It store the energy in the form of electric field or electrostatic field, while inductor store the energy in the form of electromagnetic field or magnetic field. So this is the difference between inductor and capacitor. Inductor store the energy in the form of electromagnetic field, and capacitor store the energy in the form of electrostatic field. So basically, capacitor consisting two conducting surfaces or two conductors which are separated by insulating material, that material is called dielectric. So basically, capacitor consisting two conducting plates, construction of the capacitor has been shown here in the slide. So capacitor consisting two conducting surfaces or plates which are separated by insulating material, that is called dielectric. Now capacitor passes AC and blocks DC. This is a property of capacitor: passes AC and blocks the DC, while inductor passes DC and block AC. So this is a symbol of capacitor. C is what? Capacitance of capacitor. Capacitance is denoted by C. The capacitance is the ability of capacitors to store the energy. It is denoted by C. So how the capacitor looks, it is shown here. Now next topic is classification of capacitor. So according to the which basically capacitors are classified into two types: fixed and variable, as like the resistor and inductor. Fixed and variable. Then in fixed there are two types: electrolytic and electrostatic. Electrolytic and electrostatic. In electrolytic there will be polarities to the terminals of capacitor. In capacitor there are two terminals. So in electrolytic capacitor there will be polarities to the terminals, positive and negative. But in electrostatic capacitor there will be no polarity. Any terminal we can place in the electronic circuit. So this is about the fixed capacitor and variable capacitor. In variable capacitor there are four types: ceramic, air, mica and plastic. Again in electrostatic there are four types: mica, ceramic, plastic and paper. So according to the which type of dielectric material used in the making of capacitor, there are four types: mica, ceramic, plastic and paper. Okay, so these are the four materials which are the used as a dielectric in between two conducting plates or conductors in the capacitor. So here already I have told electrolytic means what? They are polarized capacitors. Electrolytic means what? There will be polarities. So they are polarized capacitor used for the large amount of capacitance. Are used when the large amount of capacitance is required, and while the electrostatic capacitors are non-polarized capacitor. So for non-polarized capacitor, there are no polarities, and polarized capacitor, there are the polarities to the terminals. So these are the symbol for the non-polarized and polarized capacitors. Now next topic is what specifications of capacitors. So this is only listing given the capacitive reactance. It is denoted by XC. XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. F is what here, frequency, and C is what, capacitance. So XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. Next one is what, power factor, dissipation factor, voltage rating, insulation resistance, tolerance, and temperature coefficient. Now next one is what are the applications of capacitors. Capacitors are used in the integrator circuit, differentiator circuit, then it is used in oscillator circuit, it is used in the filter circuit, it is used in the multivibrator circuit, and it is used in the amplifiers. So this is a listing, this list only you have to remember. In capacitor also there is a color coding for obtaining the capacitance value. So this steps has been given for three bands. First band is the first digit, second band is the second digit. So we have to, same table we have to remember, first band indicates first digit, second band indicates second digit. Now third band is what, multiplier. Third band is multiplier. So and fourth band, now in this case there in capacitor there will be only three bands. So first band is first digit, second band is second digit, and third band is what, multiplier. And after then we have to multiply by 10 raised to minus 12. Every time you have to multiply by 10 raised to minus 12. Unit of capacitance is what, farad. So farad will be unit of capacitance. Suppose an example has been given, color band is what, orange and blue. Orange means what, which value, 0 indicates what, black, 1 indicates brown, red indicates 2, and orange indicates 3. So orange means what, 33, okay. And blue indicates what, multiplier. Third band indicates what, multiplier. Multiplier will be what here, blue. For blue what is the multiplier, 10 raised to 6, okay. So 33 into 10 raised to 6, this, and after then you have to multiply by 10 raised to minus 12. So what will be value of this capacitance, 33 into 10 raised to 6 into 10 raised to minus 12, means what, 33 into 10 raised to minus 6. Minus 6, 10 raised to minus 6 indicates what? Micro. So what will be value of this color band of capacitor? 33 microfarad. So this, like this, you have to obtain the capacitance value from the three band. And if there are four bands of capacitor, so what will be steps here? Now in this, suppose in this case fourth band, if there is a fourth band will be tolerance. So in this case yellow, example has been given, yellow, violet, orange and silver. Yellow means what, which color, which value, 4. Or after orange, which band is, color band is what, yellow. Yellow means what, 4. And violet means what, 7, 47. So orange, for orange what is the multiplier, 10 raised to 3. Value of orange is what, 3. And what will be multiplier, 10 raised to 3. So 47 into 10 raised to 3. Now after then, always in capacitor you have to multiply by 10 raised to minus 12. And here silver has been given, fourth band is what here, silver. Silver means what is the tolerance, plus minus 10%. So what will be value, 47 into 10 raised to 3 into 10 raised to minus 12 plus minus 10%. So minus 12 into 10 raised to 3 into 10 raised to minus 12, that means what, 10 raised to minus 9. So 47 into 10 raised to minus 9 plus minus 10%. 10 raised to minus 9 means what? Nanofarad, nano. So what will be value of capacitance? C is equal to 47 nanofarad plus minus 10%, like this. So this is like this, we have to obtain the value, capacitance value by using color coding. Okay students, these are the assignment questions that these questions are very important, you have to solve it. So first one is what, classify the electronics components. Second question, distinguish an active component and passive components. Third one is define resistor. So the symbol of fixed and variable resistor. Third, next question is what, classify resistor and list the its specifications. So we have to only list the specifications. Okay, so next question is what, define the inductor. Draw the symbol of fixed and variable inductor. And then next one is what, list the classified inductor. And then list the specifications and applications of inductor. Same question for the capacitor, different capacitor or the symbol of fixed and variable capacitor, classify the capacitor, list the specification and applications of capacitor. And next one is what, find the resistance value from the color bands. So for color bands has been given, from the color bands you have to find the resistance value. So these are the board questions I have given in the assignment. So in this video we have seen the all passive components. In next video we will see the electronic signals and voltage and current sources. So thank you dear students.